I guess. Okay, so put the voice on. And we're good. Can you see good, Alex?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Here we go. Time to absolutely butcher Mae Boraski. Gracias. Emo. Love me some emo bitches. I'm gonna try to do everything with like straight-ish lines. So it looks all triangle-y. Because I feel like that fits Mae's aesthetic.
Shapes.
Yes. Have very messy lines, and I don't want it like that. Meet me in the pit. That's disgusting. Absolutely hideous. I would put music on, but then it would echo. You feel me? You sounded like Dorian for a second there. Rip. That actual garbage can.
Yeah, that sounded like Dorian.
That actual garbage can.
That gay.
Yeah.
Real gay. Happy Pride Month.
DeviantArt had a little thing, like a pride flag or whatever, and it was the worst thing.
Well, I think my favorite thing about Pride Month is seeing the straight people complain, like, where's straight pride?
My favorite thing about Pride Month is watching Sense8. But, guess what?
Ah!
in the distance, look at me, and take this seriously.
I am.
You're not. Because if you were, you would roll your eyes at me when I bring it up.
I'm sorry.
It's not an I'm sorry. I've been telling you this for 2.5 weeks now. What do you need to do?
More than
that. Thank you. Because if he admit that, dude, what would we be doing? Thank you. Yes, but if you're out there with them, what's your job?
Watch them.
And when someone comes to the door, thank you.
I'm that one kid who gets yelled at on a live stream. Is it raining?
Huh?
I was wondering if it was raining. Elizabeth? Anyways. How are you? Anyways, I couldn't hear you. How are you? Hold on.
Silliest of Sallys. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Hobbs, leave him alone. Come here.
And I yell at my dogs on the live stream too. I'm amazing. Anywhom. I haven't eaten dinner yet and I'm suffering. You know that feeling? Oh. My parents aren't here, so otherwise I'd be eating. A nice home-cooked meal. Hello, Sally. Is it showing up on the stream? Alex, is it showing up on the stream? Is the stream good?
I'm gonna check. Yeah.
Okay.
I haven't held my gecko in a while. It's like really small compared to my bearded dragon now.
Aww. Oh, baby.
I'm gonna get pretty old. You're like 6 or 7 now, I think.
Aww. Old man.
Both of mine are female, I think.
Oh, old woman. Old ladies.
Well, I mean, we're middle age. These things live up from like 15 to 20 years.
True. I want a turtle.
I'm maybe this gecko's going through a midlife crisis. I don't know. It always looks like it's staring.
Put, like, a mini emo wig on it. I dare you.
What if I name my gecko B?
Do it.
Just because.
Shit, fuck.
Yeah, I'm gonna call her B.
Wait, you haven't named her yet?
I just said that I'm bad at names.
Oh, it's okay. I'm bad at names too, don't worry. I mean, I didn't even name my
dragon. I don't know what to name my bearded dragon at all.
That's so easy.
And if I decided to let Twitter decide, that would not be good.
That's so easy. Dilly. Dilly the bearded dragon. After Dilophosaurus. I'm
gonna wait them real quick, see how like this thing is.
I am the biggest dinosaur nerd there ever was.
Sally, what are you doing? Bucky, stop trying to eat your tail.
You're gonna fall off of that couch, dog. Hello, Lizzie. Hello, sister.
Sister.
Young rat.
I always roll the R with that.
Rat.
Young rat.
So, you know Supernatural, right? Everybody who's on Tumblr knows of Supernatural. But,
I haven't watched it, but
it was decent for a few seasons, but like, the actors for Sam and Dean, they can roll their R's better than most, like, Spanish-speaking people I know. And it makes me so mad because they're white as hell.
I mean, I think all my R's easily. I grew up speaking Tagalog. This is similar to Spanish.
Mm-hmm.
I know with my retainers. Like,
I just know how to roll my R's because I used to do it all the time whenever I was little. That was like my favorite pastime, just sitting there rolling my R's. Just.
Here's a song. Like, yeah, Leo Latam, you know, song, you know, looking like this.
Oh my, looking like this.
Like when they roll the R and for like riding the 305 Ferrari.
Yeah. God bless that song. I'm looking like this. I'm looking like this. So that I'm not at all. I'm looking like this. I'm looking like this. Think I'm sorry, but I'm not. You got that song stuck in my head. Thanks, Alex. Huh? Try giving them lettuce.
First thing only eats, like, oh, what's the powder thing? Next to water.
Give them lettuce. Lettuce is basically just water. Well, if you give them iceberg lettuce specifically, that's just water, so they can eat that and they won't get.
The thing is, it's not recommended to feed your dragon. Sure, maybe like crested
dragon. Iceberg lettuce is just water, though, so I think you could feed it that. Oh my god. My sister wants a bearded dragon. My mom won't let us have one. Ugh.
Lettuce isn't recommended.
Not even iceberg lettuce?
Like, the thing is, it's like, not really nutritional for them.
Well, yeah, iceberg lettuce isn't nutritional for anybody except for dehydrated people. It's just water. What? No? I'm not hungry? Okay.
There's mashed potatoes.
You're a mashed potato. You're a polo sausage.
There's steak.
I'll have polo sausage.
Potatoes.
I'll have polo sausage.
There's still some,
I'll have polo sausage.
Come on, let me get it out.
I don't.
There's still.
What's it called? I can't think of the word.
What are you drawing?
A cat.
You're a cat.
You're a cat.
What are you saying?
I don't know.
How's your face? Is it soft?
I guess.
Mm.
Except it didn't get anything from the nose.
That's okay. It's not supposed to, like, peel off.
Well, like, my nose feels like trash.
Do you want to use a pork strip?
No.
Why? It'll help your nose. It'll help your nose feel better. Come get food. Come on.
Okay, hold on.
Right now. No, hold on. Come on. Up to Vivo. Let's go.
You're an idiot. No.
Teenage boy. Why would he be my friend then? I'm not pubescent.
Well,
sausage and sauerkraut?
Why
does
Roger eat garlic potato?
I don't know. You're a garlic potato. You're technically, like, 7% banana.
I can't hear you.
You're technically, like, 7% banana.
No. You're 7% banana.
You're 7% banana. There's gotta be at least 7. Well, you're not wrong. What are you whoa-ing? Oh, yeah. Yeah? Because it was super bright out, and Mom had all of the lights on in the house. Sally didn't get up for a second there. She was like, should I go? What are you feeding them? Yes, I see you and I love you very much, but go! Sit! Hi, Bucky. I see you, baby. I see you. I'm still mad that they canceled Sense8. Are you listening to jazz? What?
This girl that I know, she's in a band. She's not really good.
I could kind of tell, I just didn't want to be rude. Bucky, what are you doing? No. Bucky, what are you doing? are you doing, stinker?
What are you watching? Oh. I see you, Bubs. Huh? Talking to Bucky. Stupid stadium.
Let me know. Everything's alright.
No! No!
What you do to me?
Oh, I'm so tired, and let me know. Everything's alright. Hooked on a feeling, I'm high on believing, you're in love with me.
Lips as sweet as candy, its taste is on my mind. Girl, you got
me thirsting for another cup of wine. From you, girl, I don't need no cure. I just stay on drinking if I can't for sure.
Good night.
When
we're all alone, keep it up, girl.
Then you turn me on. I'm high on believing
that you're in love with me.
We can be.
All the good girls.
Hey. It's got sour cream and cheese.
Are you gonna go upstairs?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I will.
I'm believing.
You're in love with me.
Up, girl. Yeah, you turn me on. What's your
feeling?
You want McDonald's tea is what you want. I was right. Can you not turn on music, please? Bailey?
Bailey!
It's fine. Love you, B.
Love you too. What's drawn?
A cat. What are you making? Oh yeah, they do that to mom all the time. Okay. Honey, honey. Yo.
Yeah, my dog is in fucking Texas. Or like 20.
What?
My mom came in.
And?
Made me like trim bearded dragon's claws or something.
Oh. This is looking terrible, but also great.
Like the eyes, the nightmare eyes.
Thank you. I'm gonna get the background made. Honey, honey. Can't go, can't swim. Not canvas. Layer. So it's a dark blue. Okay. actually looks kind of cool. Don't judge me, TM. Get swole.
Thick. A few months ago, it could sit on my index finger. And now, like, its tail goes all the way down my forearm.
Rip.
And here's the thing, it's only, like, halfway through growing.
That's on a bike. And you got me once in your Sally girl. Oh, honey, honey. Hi, Hubs. You are my candy girl. You are my candy girl. Oh, honey, honey. No. Huh? Hold on. Hey. Hold on.
Bucky Sally!
What's up? Alex. The stream lagging for you? Oh, never mind. What? Continue.
So, the Philippines, Philippines, like, it's really not a good place.
Oh.
Like, some armed gunmen got into, like, a Resorts World Manila, which is where I was born.
Oh.
And, like, the police just got in and they found 34 bodies.
Christ.
And most of them were women.
Solve mommy issues with your mom, not the public.
So I'm just gonna
usually that's where hatred of women starts. I know a lot about serial killers, don't get me started. Okay.
Like, I can, it's nice, it's like, not that, I mean, it's like, alright.
that even count?
Like Rob Knight has videos detailing serial killers and what they did.
Oh, yeah. Then yeah, it does count. Okay. But like with my... I love serial killers. Serial killers are my forte, which is why I want to be a coroner when we get older. I want to help solve those crimes, but...
I'm gonna post the link on my Twitter, but there are some people who follow me. Like, I don't know who are kind of dickheads.
Yeah. You know those random follows that you get, and it's just for people trying to get follows back? Like, a YouTuber will follow you, like, and you're just, I tweet about K-pop, where did you come in? Oh my god, did you hear that BTS unfollowed PewDiePie?
Unfollowed or followed?
Or, like, they totally, like, unfollowed him on Twitter. And he posted this video.
How do people find this stuff out?
He posted a video about it. He was like,
is this something for Drama Alert Nation?
But he like posted a video of him soaking wet for some reason. He was like, why did you unfollow me? I love you so much and I support you. I was like, me too. Because I mean, if I got unfollowed by BTS, I would be crying. Luckily, they don't even follow me. I get really sad whenever I think about them never knowing me. It's Palace, you're emo.
Insert Skrillex tweet saying, yeah, emo, who fucking cares?
I hate Skrillex. The worst. He's so bad. You know?
I've never heard much of their music, and I've never been interested in her, like, they're just, like, the kind of dubstep where you have no idea what you're listening to.
I mean, I think that's all dubstep.
Yeah.
I don't like the very,
I don't get dubstep, to be honest.
I used to like it. I like the calmer ones, like, the ones that could put you to sleep. Those are really nice, but everything else is just sort of...
Like the hardcore dubstep, I just don't understand.
Yeah.
It's like the electronic version of a really hardcore heavy metal.
But really hardcore heavy metal has words, so I guess... You can see the appeal in that. Because usually singers are how we like connect. Me, it's on a really deep level.
That's deep, man.
My maze showing.
I'm gonna be seeing Wonder Woman this weekend.
Yes.
DCEU's first not terrible movie.
I don't know. What was the good one? It was a good one. I remember it being a good one.
Okay, there's four movies considered in the DCEU right now. Man of Steel was okay.
Yeah.
It wasn't good. And then there was Batman v Superman and Suicide Squad, both of which I hated.
Suicide Squad was decent for me, because, like, I love Harley Quinn. They totally butchered her.
Yeah, like, they butchered the characters.
Yeah, I do like Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn, though.
Deserves better.
Yeah. But, like,
this is the first DCEU movie that's actually critically acclaimed.
With Harley Quinn, I'm not, like, most girls. I don't like her as in, like, the villain. I like her whenever she saves dogs. And for me, whenever I first, like, saw that part of the comic, I was like, I like her. She is who I aspire to be. Killing men. Saving dogs. Poison Ivy saves women. Gotham? Have you ever heard of it?
The show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The best TV show DC has ever put out. They have Poison Ivy.
I know the actor for the Joker is a pretty good one.
Oh, yes.
Better than Jared Leto.
Oh, yes. Kevin Monaghan? Hell yeah.
Is he good as in best since Heath Ledger good?
He's almost better than Heath Ledger. Like, you could just tell he was, like, as soon as he came on the screen and you found out he was Joker, you were like, this is the guy.
I'm not sure if it was you who sent it, but there was, like, a clip of him.
I might not have, because I haven't watched it in a while.
He didn't have the makeup on anyway.
Oh, yeah, because with Gotham, they don't have any of that yet. It's, like, it's all the babies. Like, they have baby Catwoman.
It was, like, before,
It was before, Bruce's parents died, and thank God they have the...
But he was still, like, a kid, like, mm-hmm. An orphanage or something.
They have the best Alfred I've ever seen. Like, God bless him. And the actor is so good, and all of the people on that show are just amazing. I used to watch it because it was on before The Following, which I was a huge fan of. And I got into it, and I was like, this is my new thing. I role-played.
7.9 out of 10 is a pretty good score.
Mm-hmm. I think, it's like, have you watched Stranger Things?
Yes, I have. It's a good show.
It's almost as good as Stranger Things. That's a feat.
Stranger Things. Wow.
Stranger Things is the
highlight.
It's
really rare to have something have like a 9 or above an IMDb.
Yeah.
Like, all of IMDb.
Okay, but I'm gonna be...
Like, there are only 3 movies that are 9 or above, I think. Or 4. Three or four.
I think Lord of the Rings is one.
I think I can like, list all of them.
Lord of the Rings better be one because
it was
that
The Godfather,
was...
The Godfather Part 2, The Shawshank Redemption, and The Dark Knight. Those 4.
That's bull. Lord of the Rings is the best movie there is. One of the best.
I think Lord of the Rings is an 8.7 or 8.8.
Oh, come
on.
Lord of
the Rings is an IMDb top 250. Look it up.
That was an amazing movie.
Okay, so The Shawshank Redemption is a 9. Oh, I need to look at more modern one because The Dark Knight would bump back up too.
So,
The Dark Knight's at 8.9. There are only 3 movies that are 9 or above.
Damn.
Shawshank Redemption, The Godfather, and The Godfather Part 2.
Was The Godfather even that good?
Yeah, people considered either The Godfather or The Shawshank Redemption to be the best movie of all time. Because both of them have a 9.2.
I don't think, I don't believe in that. I like to believe
okay,
in,
so
like...
after that is The Dark Knight with 8.9, 12 Angry Men with 8.9, Schindler's List with 8.9.
Schindler's List was good. I haven't even seen it, but I know it was
I
good.
I haven't seen it.
I think my sister has. Also, so...
Pulp Fiction has an 8.9. The Return of the King, Lord of the Rings, is an 8.9.
Yes.
Eighth place. The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, 8.8. Fight Club, 8.8. Fellowship of the Ring, 8.8. Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, 8.7.
Really?
Yeah.
Star Wars is...
other movies that are 8.7 are Forrest Gump, Inception, Lord of the Rings, Two Towers, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Goodfellas, The Matrix.
Okay, but... Star Wars is considered one of the biggest movies of all time. Star Wars is the biggest movie of all time. Like,
yeah,
movie series. Other and Star Trek is the biggest TV show, but it's like...
yeah, Star Wars Episode 5 has an 8.7. Like, The Empire Strikes Back is what people consider the best Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Mm-hmm. I love Star Wars. I used to hate it, and then
and, you know, The Force Awakens, like, my dad was, like, saying that it was almost as good as The Empire Strikes Back.
Right?
That's kind of taking a lot from a Star Wars fan who, like, who was alive.
Yeah.
Saw movies in theaters,
Rey?
Like, my dad.
Rey is
my
wife.
Was, like, 12.
Rey is my wife. Okay, but I'm gonna be 11 for Halloween.
Okay, like, I've heard this, like, so far that I wanted to see if I could be Carl Grimes.
Do it.
Halloween.
You'll never know until you try. I was Link.
I get the eye bandage thing.
Yeah. I was Link one year.
And I can buy, like, that little makeup. Or, like, I can get the makeup thing and not do the bandage and just have, like, the eye wound.
I'm gonna do, like, the little blood coming out of my nose and have, like, an Eggo waffle.
I mean, I remember watching the Super Bowl. But, like, that's the time where everyone pretends to care about football.
But it's mainly the commercials.
And then, like, I look up, and then I see, like, hey, why is there, like, a really old Eggo commercial? And then it cuts down to someone screaming, Aladdin, and I'm like, holy shit. and then I realized this is the Stranger Things Season 2 trailer. And I lost my shit.
Yes. Yes, hunty. I hate my life.
Yas.
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 Yas. I'm cringing into hell.
What movies I recognize on the top 250? The Silence of the Lambs, that's a good movie.
Oh, I love it.
8.6.
I'm cringing so hard, I'm in hell.
I cringed myself to implosion.
Exactly.
Spirited Away has an 8.5.
Oh, that was the one Japanese movie that everybody likes. The anime movie. That I haven't seen.
How does Interstellar have an 8.5?
I guess for how,
really?
Like, the graphics, or, like, whatever, the special effects.
I guess, but...
That
but Rotten Tomatoes only 85% liked it, and, like, I mean, it's Christopher Nolan, yes, but the ending was, like, nonsensical, really.
Yeah. Special effects usually are a big part of the movies.
Oh, yeah, like...
That's why Stranger Things...
If you're talking about visuals, Interstellar was fantastic.
Yeah. Like, Stranger Things, if it was by special effects, Stranger Things would be the best video, or best TV show.
Casey Affleck was...
This is so difficult.
Oh.
That
was
What?
Yeah, Casey Affleck was in Interstellar.
Yeah.
That guy, and he was like the shitty older brother that nobody likes.
Me too. I'm that older brother.
Pretty. I thought Casey Affleck has like a bunch of controversy around them for harassment.
Everybody does. Like, once a pop star starts to, like, rise to fame again, or, like, rise to fame in general, or not a pop star, a movie, an actor, big whatever, star. Yeah, they always have controversy about them. That's why I usually, like, with Justin Bieber, there was videos of him doing stupid stuff, so I never liked him. But, like, with, Dylan and Cole Sprouse.
I heard that Justin Bieber was legitimately, like, not good.
He's not.
He's, like, a shit person. Like, kind of like Katy Perry.
Yeah. Okay, but, like, I hated Halsey for a little bit, and then BTS took a picture with her, and she was, like, super polite. She was super polite to them, and I was like, okay, I like you now, but only because you're polite to my boys. I'm the pickiest person. I think...
Oh, yeah, Matt Damon was Dr. Man. I've been, like, Matt Damon. Like, I have nothing against him, but
he
his
was
role
good.
In the Great Wall was questionable.
He was good in the Bourne movies.
Oh, yeah, like, Jason Bourne, the one that came out, it was disappointing compared to the other ones.
Oh, yeah.
Especially since Paul Greengrass directed it, who was the director of the last, the Bourne Supremacy and the Bourne Ultimatum, I think.
Mm-hmm. Well, the first one is always
really,
the best.
He did a really good job with those, huh?
The first one is always the best.
Yeah, the Bourne Identity still had, like, the mystery aspect to it, which I liked.
Yeah. I think.
But I love how Matt Damon was in space for like 2 years in these movies because he was in Interstellar and then The Martian right after.
Oh, I thought you meant like actually in space, and I was like,
no.
Alex, I don't think he was.
Like, in his movies, he was in space.
Yeah, I was about to say, Alex.
Like Interstellar and The Martian.
I
really like The Martian. Like, I read the book too.
I have not. Is it good?
Like,
when?
I made it PG-13, but the book had, like, really strong language and stuff. If they had that language in a movie, it would probably be rated R for it.
Do you know why Logan was rated R?
Yes, because I watched it.
But the...
It was a really hard R.
Like, the actual reason, though, was because of how many times Xavier said, fuck.
Yeah.
I was so surprised whenever I heard him cuss. I was like, this is not the Xavier I know. And then I read.
Xavier say fuck.
Yeah. My Xavier never said those harsh words.
Must mouth feel good. Not being held back by that PG-13 rating.
Oh, yeah. Okay, but you know how old...
I feel like Deadpool was the one that, like, let them do that.
Yeah. You know how old, Sir Patrick Stewart was in that movie? Or, like, he had barely any makeup on, you know? I was like, I can't believe they killed Professor X. I can't believe they killed Xavier off to my dad. And my dad goes...
Yeah, and then, in the end...
No, my dad goes, well, Patrick Stewart is gonna die soon anyway, so I mean...
Oh my God.
My dad loves Patrick Stewart with all his heart, but he's, like... He's old.
So how does your father feel about Sir Patrick Stewart forcing the poop emoji in the emoji movie?
Oh, he hasn't. He hasn't even seen trailers for it. Thank God. The only reason I would ever go see the emoji movie is for that.
But the thing is, there's a better movie coming out that weekend that I want to see. So.
Oh, yeah.
Atomic Blonde.
I never saw any trailers for that. Also, did you know that they're not even putting that much money into promoting Wonder Woman? There are no billboards. There's nothing. Also, can you share my stream?
I have on Twitter.
Oh. What the heck? Did it freeze again? Then it froze again.
Well, like, Atomic Blonde is by the director of John Lynch and stuff, but it's Charlize Theron. It was,
yeah.
You know, Furiosa and Mad Max and stuff, but...
Mm-hmm.
The reason some people are saying, ugh, I don't like this movie, is because she makes out with a woman in the movie.
I love the gays.
I'm pretty sure, like, canonically...
I love the gays.
Yeah, like, the main character of Atomic Blonde is bisexual.
I love the gays.
It's like John Wick, but lesbians.
Yeah. I love how, in Finding Dory, people were losing their shit about the gay couple in, like, the background or whatever. Ellen.
It's like, wow, I can't believe they are shoving it in their faces when it appears for 0.2 seconds.
And I cannot believe Ellen DeGeneres is a homosexual. Ellen voices Dory.
Yeah.
Hi, sweeties. I love you. Hi, Sally.
Yeah. And Ellen is super gay.
Now my favorite part of Finding Dory is like the one part like when Dory found the place because he heard Sigourney Weaver's voice.
I love it. I think my favorite part and
I love Sigourney Weaver, she's great.
My favorite is the mom and dad, no doubt. Like and how she followed the shells.
Mommy, shells, and then they found her. They were so happy. It was,
Mommy likes purple shells. Break my frickin' heart.
Also, Gerald.
This is my favorite.
Gerald is like my son.
I love this. Shut up, you small.
Oh, the witch dagger one. Like the fifth picture.
Mm-hmm.
One of the witch costumes, the witch dagger one.
Yeah.
It's a really big one. I love that.
Yeah, I love that one.
Witch dagger. Damn right.
One of my friends.
Smash capitalism.
One of my friends has a boyfriend, and it's super cute whenever he talks about him. God. I love the gays.
I have a very good relationship with the gays.
I just love them. What if a homophobe fell in love with a gay man?
I mean, there was like a headline. I don't know if it was like satirical, but it was so great. I think it was the one that was straight man who doesn't wanna be homophobic to gay roommate realizes he's fallen in love with him.
My favorite is like just. Hold on, let me find it. I love their tweets. Hold on. Whenever I open Twitter, this is the first page that's. Yeah.
Wow, I cannot believe that maybe is canon.
Is it?
Totally.
Oh.
be as canonically straight that I had Kevin or as bi.
Mm-hmm. Where is it?
Was I like the only one who knew that Powerpuff Girls Z was a real show?
I've never heard of it.
It's like Powerpuff Girls the anime.
Oh.
Like, I used to watch it as a kid. I didn't know that nobody knew about it.
Yeah, also here. Oh my god. Also,
oh, that is also gross.
Mm-hmm.
Rednecks are whack.
Yeah. My, god, what is it? I don't know what I was gonna say. Shoot.
Damn it,
so, have you watched Sense8 yet? Yeah.
No, I haven't.
It's super pro-LGBT. There's a, one of the main characters is a trans woman. And she
maybe I'll watch that after I completely ruined my life binge watching Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
But she's also, she has a girlfriend, and they got married in the last episode, the series finale. And the series finale was a total cliffhanger, and I hate how they ended it. But,
they cancel it?
Yeah.
Netflix canceled it.
Yeah. But, like, one of the other men...
Continue 13 Reasons Why.
Yeah. But with, one of the other characters was gay, and he went to a parade, like a gay parade, and it was so cool, and he was an actor, and, like... The reason that's such a big deal, I'm not just saying, like, oh, he was an actor, that was his job. There was a picture of him having sex with his boyfriend, right? But in Mexico, it's not legal to be gay yet. And that's where he's from. He speaks Spanish, he was born there, yeah. And so he lost his job, and he had to try and find all these roles that were offered to him, and they were all about, like, gay men being rejected. And it was so real. And you could just really connect with the characters. It was... honestly, amazing. And, like, they filmed all over the world. Like, they filmed in Kenya, they filmed in South Korea, they filmed in America, they filmed in England, Iceland. They filmed in India, they filmed in Mexico, they filmed in Germany, and they brought up, like, the Nazis in Germany sometimes, and it was a very real show. I mean, other than the part that they were all connected telepathically.
Strangers from different parts of the world just suddenly become Sense8 human. Yep.
And it got canceled, and my sister was like, I heard my sister yelling about it, and I was like, what's wrong? And she was like, Sense8 got canceled, and I was about to cry. It's such an amazing show. and, like, you know that the actors aren't, like, homophobic or anything, because
Netflix are, like, oh, what? The Wachowskis.
What?
The Wachowskis, I think.
I don't know what that is.
Okay, the Wachowskis. They are one of the program creators. And I think they also directed and made the Matrix trilogy.
What? And did they work on Sense8?
Yeah, they're one of the creators.
Jeez. Sense8 was a gem. And, like, it taught me more about the, like, how birth happens than...
No, I didn't know they were trans.
Yep.
They were also, they were always mentioning that the Wachowski brothers, and I'm like... Transphobes, I guess. But I guess the Matrix was 1999.
Yeah.
Before they came out, I think.
Yeah. So, I mean, technically, you can still refer to them as... Like, if you're referring to the Matrix trilogy.
Like, the Wachowski sisters directed that.
Like,
Matrix, good movie.
God, I just... I loved how... different everything was. They had, like, they dealt with the problem of AIDS in Kenya. Like, one of the main characters, his mother has AIDS, and so he has to get her medicine. And he drives this bus.
It's like a really diverse cast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's so... It's,
do they ever give a reason why?
I don't think so. It was a really big show, too, so, I mean... Like, a lot of people liked it, because of how, like, diverse it was. It was Netflix...
Right after they canceled The Get Down.
Yeah.
Which I also still need to watch. Right now, I still have another, like... 3.5 seasons left of Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
With Sense8, it was Netflix's...
It also has a pretty nice cast. I mean, like, the new captain that they had is gay. And is, like, married to his husband.
Good. With Sense8, it's Netflix's most diverse cast they've ever had. Or, like, most diverse...
What I hope is that another one of the characters that I really like. Like, if you looked in the Discord chat, we were talking about Rosa... Like, almost, like, 100% bisexual, I swear to God.
Good. Sense8 is the most diverse show on Netflix. I will never shut up about Sense8. It was such a good show. And they dealt with, like, women being oppressed and how... in Korea, or in, like, how Chinese company,
yeah,
or, like, industry.
Yeah, South Korea, like, really socially conservative.
It's actually becoming a lot better, though. Like,
yeah.
The last president was a woman, so, I mean, but, like, they talked, there was this
the
one...
The thing is, the problem, what didn't help with President Park is that she was proven to be corrupt.
Yeah.
And was jailed. Like, that can't rub off well on the conservative voters of South Korea.
I think the
it's
new...
really a shame that the first female president they had was her.
Yeah, the new president, though.
I can imagine that.
He's a pretty good guy.
He was the more liberal party. Yeah, and then people were thirsting over his bodyguard.
Oh god, his bodyguard is so hot. My favorite thing about him, though, is, or no, my favorite thing, like, about South Korea, though, is not very many of the conservatives are against, like, cross-dressing. Because men in South Korea wear makeup all the time. Like, more men buy, what are they called? God, I forgot what they're called, but, like, more men buy makeup than women do. Which is a huge thing. I think they talked about that on Bill Nye.
Yeah, on the episode.
With Amber and Johnny!
Amber!
And Johnny. Johnny's a hottie. I love Johnny.
Bill Nye's how I first found out about Amber.
Really?
But I immediately, like, love her.
Oh, yeah, she's amazing. I wish he was able to speak to her in all of her, like, three languages that she knows. That would be a dream for me. Because she's so talented, and she's so, like, unrecognized. Whenever I saw the Sex and Genders one, I was like, oh, cool, this is gonna be super fun, and then he was like, we're going to South Korea to talk about K-pop, and I was jumping in my chair. Like, my dad was like, okay, Gracie, you need to calm down. Stop bouncing. And, like, after that, I explained to my dad, like, why I love her so much and how much of a role model she is to me. My dad was like, well, I'm glad you know how to choose a good role model. There's a song by her you need to listen to, and it's called Borders. It's kind of sad. But it's worth it.
Wait, is she like in a band or trio?
Yes, she was in FX before it disbanded. Well, I think it disbanded.
FX as in, like, function?
No. FX is in.
FX looks like function. F of X.
I know.
But yeah. Like, the X is in parentheses.
Yep.
Your most popular song is 8.5 million streams on.
Is it Four Walls?
Spotify. Yeah, it's Four Walls.
I knew it. Four Walls is a great song. Don't quote me on that pronunciation. Night in my pants.
She's good. I'm guessing this part is Amber.
The deep part?
I recognize the voice. Like, the rapping?
Yep.
Yeah.
She's a rapper.
lady rapping? No. My favorite part about Amber is how amazing she is. God, I feel like some DeviantArt artist. I feel like a total DeviantArt artist. And I'm out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. God, gotta get down because I wanted it all. That was actually a good song. Coming out on vacation, I've been doing just fine. Gotta start it out with a kiss, set it in the right dance. It was only a kiss. It was only a kiss. She's falling asleep. Then he's gone. Now I'm falling asleep. And she's gonna get on the side of the snow. And she's taking a drink. Going to bed. Falling asleep. He takes off her dress. Now my feet are. Oh, I just cannot keep killing me. They're taking control. Jealousy. Through sick lullabies, joking on your alibis, but it's just the price to pay. Destiny is calling me. Cause I'm Mr. Brightside. I hate that I know every line to that song. Alex. Did you hear me sing almost the entire Mr. Brightside song?
Yep.
It's a decent song.
I don't know, like, how many songs do I have, like, the entire lyrics in my head.
I do. There's one.
I think there are some songs that I can, like, have all the lyrics in my head. I can sing it off the top of my head.
I
could do it for Skyfall.
I know.
Sabotage, Loser, Lone Digger, Batman. Oh God. That's a sign that I listen to those songs too much.
I can. I can sing one of the songs from Hamilton, and I know it by heart. God, what is it? I have the beat to Mr. Brightside in my head, so... Oh, God.
I some sad song.
Sing it.
It's like melancholy, really. I listened to that song a lot when I was in New York. So now, like, when I listen to the song, I just think of New York.
Hmm. Never knew you lived
in
New York.
It's also funny, because the song is from a movie called Synecdoche.
Hmm.
I wanted to learn the piano, but I can't find, like, the music.
Rip you. Only you. Maybe.
Movie.
It's kind of sad.
Like a lot of the songs is sad. Like the whole movie is just depressing.
My life. Mm-hmm.
Like, I didn't need the sheet music because it would seem simple enough, but there's some notes that I really don't know what they are.
Is the stream still going good?
Yeah.
I'm shading right now. Is that what you see? Okay. Well, I'm trying to make the hair look a little bit better. If you like depressing things, I suggest to you a movie called Suicide Room. It's really popular with the emo community. But it's super sad. Has gays in it, TM.
AIDS, TM.
Yep. You said so. Give it up. The Maid of Honor, Angelica Schuyler. Can't record it though.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm happy.
They're in the box theater and we're trying to get it, but the tickets are probably gonna be like really fucking expensive.
Oh yeah. My sister went and it cost her like.
We went to New York. My parents tried to get tickets so that we could see it in Broadway in New York. But it was sold out.
Oh yeah.
So, like, it was sold out for the entire week that we would be there.
Yeah, it sold out fast. Be satisfied. Rewind. I just might remember that night. I just might remember that night. I remember that. Such boys. No praise, can quite fade, but Alexander, I'll never forget the first time I saw your face. Set my heart aflame, every part of flame, this is my game. You strike me as a woman who has never been satisfied. I'm sure I don't know what you mean. Forget yourself, you are my sweet. You've never been satisfied. Never been satisfied. My name's Angelica Schuyler, Alexander Hamilton. Where's your family from? Unimportant, there's a million things I haven't done. Just you wait. Just you wait. Just you wait. Because I'm Scarlet's sister that I have satisfied. Have to be naive to set that aside. Maybe that is why I should introduce him to Eliza. Now that's his bride. Nice going, Angelica. He was right. He will never be satisfied. Eliza. No, it's Angelica. No, it's Eliza. My sister. No, it's Skylar. My sister. No. see things. Number one, I'm a girl in a world in which my only job is to marry rich. My father has my son, so I'm the one who has the social climbing one. So I'm the oldest and the wittiest and the gossip and New York City-est, insidious, Alexander-est, penniless. Huh, that doesn't mean I won. Mina, one of them. After me, because I'm Scarlet's sister, I'm gonna reach status. I have to be naive to set that up. Hey, that is why. Introduce him to the lions and all that's his plans. He's going angelic, right? He's right from every side. My sister. Number three. I know my sister like I know my own mind. You will never find anyone as trusting or as kind. I love my sister more than mine. If I would choose her happiness over mine, every time. He was right, he'll never be satisfied. You know, if Angelica had married Hamilton, he never would have cheated. You ever think about that? What other song do I know all the words to? Cold Star.
Puberty is like the worst thing for singing.
I can't relate. My voice doesn't crack that much. My voice has never really cracked. Whenever I was little, it did all the time, but that's... Women's voices don't change that much. Male voices do.
Yeah, like mine. Since I'm a guy. A male.
Mm-hmm. Like Dorian's.
Puberty, my voice.
Dorian's... Like, all the time. Dorian's voice will never change.
Dorian sounds exactly the same since...
Mm-hmm. That's because biologically...
since fourth grade.
If you are biologically female, your voice does not change very much. It stays the same for most of your life. Women mature faster than men do, that's why.
Guys.
Yeah. Men mature very slowly compared to to women. But women mature, like, earlier on than men do. Like, I started puberty whenever I was, like, 10.
I think mine was around 6th grade.
So about like 11?
Yeah. 12 actually. I was 13 in 7th grade, 14.
Yeah, I was 10 whenever I first... I was like 10 whenever I first hit puberty. And it's women hitting puberty sucks. Lucky Dorian. Dorian doesn't have to get periods anymore when he gets his surgery, and I'm jealous. I had a trans friend, and her mom was the meanest person I'd ever met, or I'd, like, ever heard of. Because her mom took hormones and she was supposed to, like, make her breast grow or whatever. And her mom, like, took them right in front of her. God, this is so hard. Help me, Alex. I kind of want to do a live stream where I just have a bunch of people ask me, like, questions.
Hey, Dorian's here.
Oh. Hey, Dorian. I have my... You can hear me, can't you? Like, on the stream.
Oh, the thing is, if I had the audio on for the stream, you'd be echoing.
Oh, well, can you just test it out for
so
a sec?
So I had the stream muted.
Mm-hmm. Can you test it out for a sec, though? Like, because I don't want it to be useless that I...
I'm going to meet the Discord real quick.
Okay. I just don't want it to be useless that I have my camera on and it's not doing anything. Or not my camera, my microphone.
The audio is delayed, but yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Yeah, like as Dorian said in the comments, it's slow.
Mm-hmm. No worries. As long as it's there. This is probably one of the worst and the best things I've ever done. Bad, but also good. How do you like it? Oh god. My tablet.
I tried to think of like a Woody Night in the Woods quote, but I had nothing.
But that cup's on my ears. Like, I don't know. My tablet screen is darker than my actual computer screen. So it's like.
Like, if mine make a little suggestion.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not sure which ear it was, but they had, like, a scarred ear.
Oh. Snap. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Good lord. Okay,
So, when May is facing you, the left ear. So, like, the one that's... Yeah.
Okay, so, like, this one?
Mm-hmm. Like, the one opposite to the moon.
Okay, yeah. Okay, there we go. God, I would be lost without you. There we go. What would I do without you, Alex? Nah. I'm good at scenery on the computer, but I'm not good at, like, characters. Better whenever it's, like, sketchy, in my opinion. Yes, sir. I'm dehydrated all the time. Oh boy. Oh boy. People like messy art, don't they? People will accept messy art, won't they? Like, I don't know, sketchy outside the lines, whatever. Huh? What?
Like, I like the stream, apparently counted as a video.
Yeah.
And I'm liking it posted to my Twitter, so is there that second share?
Thank you. People like messy art, it's fine. Plus, Night in the Woods, I don't think it's supposed to be, like, perfect. Alex. I did something good.
He does not draw art and does not understand artists.
Oh, it's like, I don't know, it's sort of like a tree, I guess. I don't know. Since it's Night in the Woods.
Symbolism.
Yeah.
Deep.
I'm gonna subtly there we go. I can't believe I just put that in actual drawing. I just put eat my entire ass in an actual drawing. Go legally brain dead by choking on my entire ass.
Lack of oxygen. Choking on my entire ass.
I love them.
Scricken is a piece of shit. You deserve that.
Did he? Really? Did he really deserve it? Okay. And then my gay signature. And we're done. Is Dorian still on? I don't think so.
It says two watching right now. Yeah. I'm one of them, so.
Yeah, and I'm one of them too, so. I'm gonna go upstairs, though. And we are going to talk. Upstairs.